Hey guys, so for number 43, we're going to simplify the radical expression and we're going to assume that all the variables represent non-negative real numbers. So that means that this m and this n is a positive real number. And then if this 144 is positive, then we're going to end up with a real number and we don't have to worry about imaginary numbers. So in order to simplify the radical expression, we're going to take out the groups of whatever the index is telling us to of each number or variable. So here the index isn't there, which automatically by default means that the index is 2. That means that we're trying to find factors that can be grouped into 2 and take them out of the root. So let's start by writing the smallest factors of 144. Now, in order to find the smallest factors, I would recommend doing prime factorization. And prime factorization is when you take the smallest factor of something and write the other factor on this side, and then keep trying to write the smallest factor using that number. So 144 is even, meaning that the smallest factor of 144 is going to be 2. So I'm gonna write that as 2 times 72, and then 72 can also be factored into 2 and 36, and then 36 into 2 and 18, and then 18 into 2 and 9, and then 9 can't be factored down anymore by the 2s, but it can still be factored even smaller into 3 and 3. So let's go ahead and write our radical again with the factors of 144 instead of writing 144. So let's go ahead and write our m to the ninth power, but because we're trying to find groups of 2, let's rewrite this in a way where we can easily see the groups of 2 factors of m. So let's rewrite that as m to the second power 4 times, because m to the second power 4 times is the same thing as m to the 8th power. And then I'm going to add the extra m to the 1 power. That way, this entire thing is equivalent to m to the 9th power. And then I'm going to do the same thing for the n. So instead of writing n to the 10th power, I'm going to write n to the second power 5 times. So now we can easily see our groups of 2. As for the constants, we have a group right here, a group right here, and a group right here. So let's take out a 2, another 2, and a 3. Now, as far as the m's go, remember that this m to the second power is m times m. So that m to the second power is a group in and of itself. So it looks like we have 2 groups of m's, 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So I'm going to take out an m 4 times. And then the same thing goes for the n's. The n's can also be rewritten as n times n. So it looks like we can take out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 groups of n's. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then on the inside of the radicand, we are still left with this m to the first power. So we're just going to go ahead and leave that. And then we're going to simplify all of this. So 2 times 2 times 3 is 12. And then I have 4 m's here being multiplied together. So I'm going to rewrite that as m to the fourth power. And then I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 n's here, so I'm going to rewrite that as n to the 5th power, and then I'm going to bring down my square root of m. And that is our final answer.